so beautiful. So beautiful. To me, can't you see? You're everything I hope for.
The first thing I would do is ask for nothing. If I was going to give Jesus rest, I wouldn't ask anything for myself. I would make my wants and my needs and my problems at that time. If I'm going to seek to give him rest, I wouldn't bring up any of my stuff. He hears that all the time. As has been said many times, come boldly to the throne of grace, so we all just come boldly there, get what we need, and leave. So I would become as self-forgetting as I possibly could. And if it's just me and him and me trying to give him rest, then the only important thing in the room is him. The second thing is that I would speak from my heart into his heart. I know that we all pray, and I know that he hears all of our prayers, and I know that he's so faithful. But what if prayers were really never meant to be religious in nature? What if they were just meant to be us talking to God, and more specifically, talking from my heart into his heart? I saw a little article that said something about, it was something entitled like this, five things that you can ask your father that will make his day on Father's Day. And basically they were either doing something special for him or talking from the child's heart, whether it's young or old or whatever. And I thought, you know, a lot of times we don't really just tell him our heart. And I'm not talking about our fears. We tell him those. God knows he gets a lot of that. But I'm talking about the things that we care about, or the things that, you know, just even ask him, what is it you really care about? And Lord, I know you may not be able to communicate that to me right now, but your spirit is in me and on me, and have him break through my world-centered, my earth world, the realm of my existence. Remember, this is how would I bring him rest, or what would I do to try to bring about rest for the Lord? I would tell him that I'm with him. I would try to communicate that, not just by those words, but that, Lord, I am with you. And, you know, we almost always have to add in, you know, even though I don't seem like it, or maybe at times I'm not, I want you to know that in my core, I am with you. I love you. I am with you. I want you. And I want what you want. Okay. So remember now, this is as if we're talking to the Lord, trying to give him rest. And we're taking all the burdens off. We're taking all of the earthly problems because, you know, he's eternal. And, you know, we only think in the realm of the earth. He doesn't think in the realm of the earth except for our sakes. But when we move into his realm, there are new questions and new realities to come to be enlightened to be brought into. I wrote down this statement. I would say, my heart beats with yours. Now, I know that saying stuff really doesn't count if we live contrary to those things. But I think even if we were totally not that way and we told him that, it would mean more than if we never said anything. And, you know, it occurs to me, even while I'm talking right here, these are things we can tell the Father, too. But can you imagine the joy of the Lord, instead of being my strength, just it being him joyful. Him, just us making him full of joy. Just to hear us say that my heart beats with yours, or I want my heart to beat with yours. We start straying a little bit when we start make my heart beat with yours, because then it's about us again. I hope you can see the difference there. And the thought of how would I bring him rest, I just jotted down this sentence. I would give what little strength the weak can offer to the great. I would give what little strength the weak can offer to the great. I mean, he's the great. And so we assume because he's the great that, you know, well, we're the weak, so this has to be this kind of relationship. You know, that. But can't the weak sometimes think, is there anything that this weak vessel can give to the great that would bless him, that would bless you, Lord? I would give what little strength the weak can offer to the great. And when I said strength, that's whatever, you know. I put the word strength because I was thinking in terms of rest, what I can do to lift the load, what I can do to cover him, what I can do to say, hey, you know, abide with me and I'm going to be a shelter for you. You know, abide with me. That's what they said. Abide with us. We will be a shelter. We will cover you. We will rest you. We will allow you rest instead of getting the word, gathering it up, everybody go to their houses. Jesus is left alone at the Mount of Olives, and he spends the night there. And then the last thing, how I would give him rest. Is that I would love him. I didn't say I would tell him I love him. That's fine. There's no problem there. Sure, that's good. But I would love him. I would just love him. And I believe that if I just loved him, that that would do more than all the teaching. Because you see, if in chapter 21, if the first goal was that they just loved him, the first goal was that they would have taken him with him. Come abide with us, instead of leaving him out in the night, in the cold, to find the Mount of Olives for him to just... Because it didn't say he went there to be with the Lord or to pray. It just says that's where he spent the night. If we love his teaching, we may listen to him and then leave and not even notice that he didn't go home with anybody. You understand. I hope you understand how I'm putting this. But if you just love him, you notice things. You go, Jesus, nobody invited you home. Come with me. And that's, I mean, God is love. That would be a wonder to him, to be loved back. To be loved back. Even if it was not as pure as his love, because none of ours is. Lord, these are heart issues, Father, and I don't know how to verbalize heart issues, but I just in this session was seeking, Father, to move the pendulum from off of us to Jesus, to draw out our hearts because we do love him, to break open our heart as a vessel of ointment, as a alabaster box. And just pour it on him. So, we ask you, Holy Spirit, and we ask you, Father, to help us to exhibit the things that are important. To find Jesus in ways beyond teaching and to love him. And to love him. So we thank you, Father. We thank you for Jesus. We thank you for giving us Jesus.
You are so beautiful. So beautiful to me. Can't you see? You're everything I hope for. Oh,